Hello guys, and welcome to this short video to talk about your careers. So what can you do after you become a dentist? Then of course you have some options. The first option here you are already seeing on the screen, so it's just to work at the clinic. But then there is a question mark. And why there is a question mark? Because you can actually work at the clinic until the end of your career, or else you can work at a laboratory. If you follow the career of oropathology, for example, you can work, depending on the country, as an ororadiologist. So of course there are other options, but the main one followed by the majority would be, of course, working at the clinic. In this case, we need to update ourselves, of course, so you need to look for ways to update yourself. So maybe you go for small courses, you need to go for books, you need to read scientific articles, because we need to keep ourselves up to date in regard to dental clinical science. What we should not do is to keep working until the end of our careers without updating ourselves. And now we have the second option, of course, which is to do the postgraduate courses, okay? So we can do, for example, a continuing education course, which is a short duration course, for example, 1 week or 2 weeks. And that's a course for you to learn how to work properly on a specific dental field. However, you have also other types of courses, so let's see how they are divided. And they are divided in two different ways according to those terms in Latin. So one of the terms is lato sensu, which means a broad sense, and that's actually referring to the way we work. So you are going to learn how to work. I'm talking about certificates, diplomas, and specialty degrees, for example, right? So a specialty degree is considered the main lato sensu course for dentists in most of the countries, and you can do that to become a periodontologist, a neuroimplantologist, or the specialty degree that is recognized in your country. So the stricto sensu, on the other hand, is for those who want to follow the academic career. So that includes a Master of Science, which would be followed by a PhD usually, and then the PhD is the highest degree that you can achieve in the academic career. However, you can still keep going and do a postdoctoral fellowship, for example, which would be a training period as an assistant professor or as an assistant faculty member. So of course there are other ways to spend your career, but those would be the main ones. And keep in mind that the more knowledge you get, the more prepared you are, then of course the better will be for your patients, for your private practice, and for your dental working career in general. So if you guys liked this video, please hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for the next videos.